Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and today I will talk about how you can create labels that actually have tappable hashtags and mentions. So without further ado, let's get to work. Now, I have created a basic template project here that we will build up from scratch in just a minute. But let me show you, this is a label that has the tribe as a hashtag and at Rebeloper as a mention. So when I tap on them, of course we can't see it now here, but if you run it in Xcode, we will have some good print statements inside our log. So this is what we are going to build. Now this can be used in social media apps. You know that hashtags and mentions are a must in social kind of apps. So let us just create a new project, and maybe just simply I need to go stop this, and let us just create a new project. Okay, let me just resize this so you may see it better. And it will be a single view application. Let's click on next. And we are going to call this ActiveLabel tutorial. Now, why is that? That is because we are going to use a GitHub repository that I absolutely love, and it is perfect for this hashtag and mention and even more handling. Okay, so let us just click on next, and we will drop it onto the desktop. We will create a Git repository on my Mac, because I will throw this up again as usual onto my GitHub repository. Just click the link down below and you will be taken to it, and you will be taken to all of the resources that are necessary to all of my YouTube videos. So go ahead and click the link down below. Okay, let's create this on my desktop. Okay. Now, first thing first, let's create, and this will, I will just go through it really fast. I will create, I will delete the main storyboard and access the view controller by code. So first of all, let us just delete our main storyboard and the reference to it too. And next up, going to app delegate. In the application did finish launching with options, let's call upon our window and the capital W window. Okay, and let's make our window key and visible. Next up, let us just create our view controller, and it is a view controller. Great. And now let's add this view controller to the Windows root view controller. Pretty easy. Now let's go to our view controller, and I will just set our view's background color to white. Okay, you have seen me do this hundreds of times if you are looking at my YouTube videos, so this should be very, very familiar and straightforward. Okay, now we are going to add a label, an active label. So we are going to use CocoaPods to import active label and to make centering and anchoring real easy for this label. We are going to use tiny constraints. So let us just close this and go to our Finder. And here we have our active label tutorial, and open up terminal. Let me just make this a little bigger so you may see what I type in. Okay, and simply just type in cd and drag and drop the root folder of your project. Hit return and type in pod in it to create a pod file. Now for the pod files, you need to add the pods. So what we're going to do is just simply drag this pod file onto the Xcode icon, and it will be open by Xcode. Next up, let's enable the platform, and the platform iOS 9.0 is okay. And next up, we add our pods. Now the first pod is active label. Great. The next is, and the final is tiny constraints. Okay, close this and let's go back to terminal and install it by typing in a pod install. Now, this should take just a few seconds. Well, it all depends on your internet connectivity. Now, we should have an Xcode workspace created for us. From now on, of course, we are using this Xcode workspace. We need to open our project with this Xcode workspace from now on because we are using CocoaPods. Now, let's go into our, first of all, let's build and run. Well, just build it out. And as you can see, we have a few, let's say errors, but because you know there is this Y dot inside the error icon, we know that it can be fixed pretty easily. Now, these errors occur because of Swift 4.2, and 4.2 has been just released, and I'm sure that in the near future, this will be figured out and updated in the active label and of course in the tiny constraints repository. So for now I would just go through it really fast and fix all of the problems. It's basic Swift 4.2 syntax issues, so we just need to handle them by just clicking simply on these fix buttons. I am pretty sure that most probably you will not have these issues, but if you have, go ahead and just fix them. Not a big deal. Okay, let's just scroll up. I forgot about one at the top. Okay, let's just scroll down. And of course, now you learn how you can fix other repositories' issues. And don't worry, if you come across an error, just try to find out what happened. This is what real programmers do. Okay, we have one last. Let's unlock this file again. And of course, we need to unlock this file. UI window. Yeah, sorry about that. It was UI window. That's why it didn't really autocomplete. Okay, let's update the to recommended settings while we are here. Great. Now we are ready to build out our application. Now we need to import here ActiveLabel and it doesn't really show up. So I would just hit Command B for building our project. And now we should be able to have that autocomplete. And here it is, ActiveLabel. And let's import tiny constraints too. Okay, first of all, let's create our ActiveLabel. So let's type in lazy var, and I will just call this label because it doesn't really matter how we call it at this instance. And it will be of type ActiveLabel. And let's just construct this here real fast and var active label, and let us just return our label. Here we have to add a label. I'm just too fast in typing label. Great. Now what we want to do next is add this label to our controller's view. So view, add subview, and a label. And with the help of tiny constraints, we will constrain it to the center of our view. So label and center in super view. Now that was really easy. Now let's set up some things for our label. So type in label and the number of lines equals 0. What this means is not 1, not 2, not 3. It is as much as we want. Now, next up, we want to align the text to be centered. So text alignment equals dot center. Okay, next up, you want to add our labels text to be, let's set the text color or better yet, we leave the text color as it is. We will add a text here, and if you haven't watched my videos on how to create these multi-line labels, then go ahead and find it on my YouTube channel. I will have a link down below and here a card. Okay, now, what text do we want to have? Well, I will type in, and the next line will be, and I will add even a dot here. Great. Now let's build and run and see how this works, because we have typed in quite a lot of code. Now it's time to see what it actually does. Okay, here we are. We have @hashtag and @mention. We already have it implemented. Now let's add a color for these hashtags. Okay, so label dot hashtag color, and that will be of type, let's say, I believe it was blue. Now let's add a mention color, and that is equal red, and let's add our label text color to be black. Okay, I believe that should be for the colors. Let's build and run and see how it looks now. Okay, pretty great. We have our blue hashtags, our red mention, and our text color. Now, to enable these hashtags and mentions, all we have to do is just set the enabled types. So label.enabledTypes, and this will be an array, and we will enable our hashtag. It is, let me just check, double check, and this is what you should do when you have, okay, here we have our enable types, and I don't want URL for now, so I'll just copy these two. So these are of type active type, but I will just copy and paste these two, so mentions and hashtags will be enabled. Now finally, we want to know whether a user tapped on a hashtag or a mention. Now that is pretty simple. So let's type in label and let's handle hashtag tap. And here we have our hashtag hash. And let's type in here, let's print it out. So let's say, and let us just name this hashtag and hashtag. Okay, now the same goes for mentions. So label handle mention tab. We add in a mention here. And let's print this out for our mention. Okay, tapped on mention and mention. Okay. Let's see how that looks. Okay, let's tap on this hashtag, and if you can see here, we have tapped on a mention on a hashtag. Let me just move this away. Now let's tap on our mention. We have tapped on the mention. So I want to again change this. Let's see in our text here, the tribe and Rebeloper. Okay, let's build and run again and see the new logs. Okay, tapped on the tribe hashtag, tapped on the Rebeloper mention, and that is great. And if you didn't already know, go ahead and check out our new store at store.rebeloper.com, where you can also join the tribe. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell in case you want to be notified instantly when I upload new videos. Now it's your turn. Go ahead and comment down below. Do you use hashtags or mentions in your app. Go ahead and comment down below. I'm really curious if you ever had a chance meeting these kind of active labels in your apps. And as always, I will see you in the next one.